Hi, it's Ritwika. Good sound quality is essential for a good video. We all know that the Canon 5D is an excellent still-in video camera, but it's not a high-fidelity sound recorder. Today, I will show you how you can use an external sound recorder to get the professional sound quality you're looking for. To do this, you will need a professional-grade sound recorder. Here, I personally use a Sony PCM-D50, but you can choose from various fine recorders from various brands, like Yamaha, Olympus, and many others. But one thing you must ensure is that your sound recorder has a sampling rate of 96 kHz at a 16-bit resolution or larger. Before we move on, let me tell you something. If you plan on buying this Sony PCM-D50, make sure you buy this windscreen as well. This is artificial fur, and you can easily make this at home by sewing pieces of artificial fur together. It fits over the microphone grill like this, and all it does is it blocks off all the unnecessary wind noises. Without this, the recorder's microphones are so sensitive, even if you move the recorder like this, it will pick up wind noises. You will also need to buy this hot shoe ball head. It has a screw that fits on the tripod mount of the sound recorder, like this, and a hot shoe, which fits on the Canon 5D. The next step is to connect the audio recorder's auxiliary output to the microphone's input of the camera. By doing this, the camera is recording what the sound recorder is recording, but in lower quality. That way, when we're video editing, the sound file and the video file is easily synced together. However, there is a technical challenge, and you cannot just connect the stereo cable to the microphone input and the auxiliary output like this, because the output signal level is way higher than the microphone's input level. If you do this, then the recording in the 5D will be heavily clipped and distorted. To solve this problem, I have made a passive attenuator, which I will show you how to do with simple components. Right now, I'm drawing you a circuit diagram, and this is how it looks like. This is the circuit diagram, but let's first look at these symbols. So this symbol over here means a resistor, and this is what a resistor looks like. And over here, this is a potentiometer. This is what a potentiometer looks like. This is the bottom view, as you can see over here, with the three wire terminals. And this is the top view. The recorder's output is getting connected to the two terminals over here. And the center terminal is connected with the resistor. And these two terminals are then connected to the 5D's microphone input. You have to do this for both the left and the right channel for the stereo output. Let me show you the components and tools you will need. As for components, you will need one stereo cable, one strip board or barrel board, two resistors, and two trim potentiometers. To construct this, you will need a soldering iron, a pocket knife, a wire stripper, a cutter, solder, flux, and a multimeter. I begin by cutting a small piece off of the strip board. Scratch the board a couple of times, then snap it to break it. Here is the tiny piece I've cut from my barrel board to construct my circuit. By the way, you can get all of these components and tools at Radio Shack. So this is the finished product. These stereo jacks are not interchangeable, so I've marked this one red to indicate that this one will be going to the camera and this one to the recorder. Now, I tune my attenuator to match my recorder's output and my camera's input. I turn my sound recording on and feed it a constant sound by humming like this. Then I adjust the sound level so it is around 12 dB. Using a screwdriver, I set the potentiometers at its midpoint and turn on the camera. Press the menu, go to live view, and manual sound recording. This will bring up the sound level meter of the camera. Start humming and use a screwdriver to set the potentiometer of both channels so that the camera's meter also reads around 12 dB. When properly adjusted, both sound levels should read about the same decibel level. Now my attenuator is all tuned and I'll protect it by using a kitchen stretch film and aluminum foil. The aluminum foil will give it electrostatic shielding, and I'll wrap some sellotape around it, or tape, to give it more protection. Now, I will show you how you can get the best sound quality using your new setup. Oh, and one more thing, you will need a clapperboard. Here, I have made mine at home using plexiglass, two wooden pieces, and a hinge. All this does is it shows you the important information you'll need, like the scene number, the take number, and the sound file. And it also makes a really nice clapping sound, which helps you sync your audio and video file when editing. As you know, videos are broken up into scenes. And over here, it shows that I'm shooting my first scene, and it's my third attempt of shooting that scene. And the sound from the scene is being recorded in this file number. And I get this file number from just locating it on my recorder. Turn on your audio recorder and set the sound level according to your recording manual. Then turn on your camera. Now, stand in front of your camera and hold the clapperboard facing the camera. Read the scene number, read the take number, and then sound the clap. Then hurry back to your camera and start shooting. At the end of your take, stop the camera and then stop the recorder by pressing the stop button, not the pause button. If you press pause, then the next sound of the next take will be recorded on the same file. When editing, you will have to separate all these files, adding more tasks. So please remember the sequence. Start sound, start camera, use the clapperboard, stop camera, and stop sound. Now, I will show you how to sync the audio files in post-processing. I am bringing my video and audio file to the timeline in Adobe Premiere. However, you can use any non-linear editor and use the same concept. Then, locate the clapper sound on the video camera's audio track and in the audio track of the sound recorder. They will look like two sharp spikes. I will drag my sound recorder's audio track to align it visually with my camera's audio track. I zoom in for better visual alignment, and then turn on Show Audio Time Unit in Adobe Premiere to get the perfect sync. My video is in sync with the recorder's track. I can safely delete the video's audio and link the recorder's audio with the video. And here is the finished product.
Scene 1. Take 3. This is our test shot, testing out our new setup.
I hope you enjoyed today's video. It was brought to you by Renaissance Now, a nonprofit that helps underprivileged artisans. If you would like to help art or artisans, please visit rennow.org and consider donating a dollar or your used art tools.